10 new facts to make you look smarter. Here, we examine 10 new facts we've never before examined, facts that will make our friends think we're much smarter when we share them over drinks. If you have any other fun facts to share with the other readers, especially facts that haven't already appeared on the lists, please use the comments. 10. Foiled by a name. To begin with, hardly anyone uses real tin foil these days. We all call it tin foil, but it's actually aluminium foil. The original foil was made of tin, which could be detected, as we might expect, in everything it touched. Despite its advantages, it may not have lasted long enough in our kitchens to replace modern aluminum foil. Despite its superiority to tin foil after the Second World War, aluminum foil had been around since 1910, when Dr. Lauber, Neyer & C., a Swiss company that uses a waterfall to power its foil-making machinery. 1913 was the first time it was used in the United States as a wrapper for Lifesavers candy. The use of tin foil to fill cavities in teeth predates the 20th century. Those of you with amalgam fillings today and who have chewed aluminium foil should squirm at this fact. 3 mindfulness tips for sharing a small living space. 9. Show me the money. Most Americans are aware that the gold in reserve at Fort Knox is stored in the United States. The truth is, it isn't. The majority of gold in the United States is stored at the Federal Reserve's Wall Street Vault. A second interesting point is that most of the gold does not even belong to the United States, it belongs to foreign accounts. If the U.S. government were to nationalize all the dollars today, that would probably be the biggest gold theft in history. Gold's real value does not fluctuate constantly, but its value changes constantly. Brand new high-quality suits cost the same amount today in gold as brand new high-quality togas did in ancient Rome. Neither gold nor us change, it is us who do. 8. Pied Piper. The long procession of children soon left the town and made its way through the wood and across the forest till it reached the foot of a huge mountain. When the piper came to the dark rock, he played his pipe even louder still and a great door creaked open. Beyond lay a cave. I trooped the children behind the Pied Piper, and when the last child had gone into the darkness, the door, it did not matter how much money the mayor refused to pay the Pied Piper to rid the town of rats that caused the whole town of Hamelin to lost all its children to the piper. If you know it is true, you might be very surprised. The gist of it is true, a few parts have been exaggerated. Here is a quote from the wall of the Piper's house in Hamelin today. In the year of 1284, on the day of Saints John and Paul, the 26th of June, 130 children born in Hamelin were seduced by a piper, dressed in all kinds of colors, and lost at the Calvary near the Copen. Many theories abound as to the factual events of that day, but the most logical seems to be that the piper represents death. Death was depicted as a skeleton wearing pied clothing in the Middle Ages, and that the children who died were killed by the plague. In Middle English, Pied Piper means a man wearing clothing in different colors. The word is derived from magpie. The Pied Piper wore clothing of many colors. 7. We Three Kings. On this one, we'll get right to it. As the biblical story of Christ's birth tells, the famous three kings were not 1, 3 in number, the number isn't mentioned at all. 2. Kings, they were wise men. This probably comes from Psalm chapter 71 verse 11, 72-11 in Protestant Bibles, and all kings of the earth shall adore him, all nations shall serve him. 3. Trotting about on camels. The actual narrative, Matthew chapter 2 verses 1-2, merely says, "When Jesus therefore was born in Bethlehem of Judah, in the days of King Herod, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem." It says a little later that they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, but that is about as specific as it gets. Interesting fact. The Catholic Bible, based on the Septuagint, Greek edition used by the Apostles and Christ, uses a different numbering system to Protestant Bibles, based primarily on later Jewish editions of the Bible. This can be very confusing when looking up quotes, as you can see above. 6. Ouch. In humans, a penis lacks a bone, it becomes erect by containing blood inside a sponge-like material. However, you can still break this vital part of your body, in a sense. If the penis is struck suddenly or if there is a sharp shock or bending, the fibrous tissue that contains the spongy material, called the corpora cavernosa, can be broken. In many cases, and rather embarrassingly for men every year, a broken penis can only be repaired by surgery. Leaving it uncorrected, a man will no longer be able to erect. The body naturally disposes of excess sperm through the urine stream, so to speak, regardless of whether men masturbate or have sex regularly. 5. Peace, or not. Despite his well-deserved reputation as a peaceful man, Gandhi wasn't always so. He did not consider violence his only option. After the attack on Hindus by Muslims, he approved the government's order to shoot 10 Muslims for every Hindu that was killed. He fought in three wars in his middle age, the Boer War, the Zulu War, and World War I. Gandhi once said about independence, "If a fight was inevitable, I would expect every citizen to contribute. I would not hesitate to sacrifice a million lives to ensure India's freedom." For years, he lived in London and wore a silk hat and spats and carried a cane, as shown above. 4. Canine kitchen. In fact, dog meat is a popular staple in many other countries, not just Asia, as well. Chinese, Vietnamese, Nigerian, Tongan, Japanese, Taiwanese, Indian, and, most surprisingly, Swiss people consume dog meat regularly. Dai Shuai's prepares Gedorts Hundefleisch, a dish of very thinly sliced dog meat, and salted raw dog meat called Hundeschinken. The cantons of North and South Tyrol produce a particular type of cured dog sausage. Food produced from dogs for human consumption is actually illegal for commercial purposes, but it is not illegal to eat it yourself. 3. Leprous lies. Leprosy does not cause flesh to rot or to lose limbs, as is commonly believed. In fact, leprosy is a disease, now known as Hansen's disease after a Norwegian physician who discovered the bacteria responsible, that damages nerve endings and damages the skin. Because of the numbness caused by those suffering from leprosy may be unaware that they have harmed themselves. This type of accidental harm can result in infections that cause amputations. In some nations like India, Japan, and China, there remain leper colonies despite leprosy being curable since the 1930s. It turns out that armadillos are carriers of leprosy and can transmit it to humans. 95% of humans are naturally immune to the disease, and the 5% that are susceptible can be easily cured of it if they become infected. 2. Drink and be merry. Taking antibiotics while drinking alcohol is not a good idea since they can treat sexually transmitted diseases. According to that reasoning, and still does, the medication will not work if this happens. As it turns out, this isn't the case. Most antibiotics are not hindered in any way by the consumption of alcohol, though it may cause a stomach upset depending on the type. The truth is, only 5 types of antibiotics that have been tested have negative effects when taken with alcohol. People with STDs are probably most likely to have casual sex when drunk, so the real reason to not drink is to prevent casual sex between them. For a short time, stopping them from drinking would often prevent them from spreading their illness to others. Interesting fact. Because of high costs involved, and low profitability, very little research is done these days in the field of antibiotics. It has been 9 years since a new form of antibiotic has been developed. 1. Bloody meat. When a rare or medium steak is served, it appears that blood is oozing from it. This isn't true, the majority of blood has been removed by the time meat reaches a kitchen for cooking. Myoglobin, the red substance you see, is a protein and water mixture. Red meat is darker than white meat because more myoglobin contributes to a darker color, less myoglobin results in lighter meat. Myoglobin changes over time, which is why red meat darkens as it ages, hence almost black, aged, steaks. Interesting fact. Crabs have blue blood, worms and leeches have green blood, and starfish have clear or yellow blood. Also, humans do not have blue blood, it is always red, though the darkness level varies. Veins are blue because of the interaction of light on our skin and the depth of the veins. Thanks for watching the video. Do share and subscribe to get updated.